Hi. So how did we go with the mutate exercises? I hope it went well. It's not the easiest of commands to learn. It's certainly a little bit more complicated than some of the other ones we've played with, but hopefully you've got the hang of it. And in a moment, I will go through the exercise that we just said. As is my wont, as I kind of introduce these things and tab back over to the section, I should mention an entertaining little fact about how I am making these things. So I chose to wear the sunglasses because that way you can't see where my eyes are looking exactly, and it breaks the effect you get in these videos of weird eye contact, like where I'm not looking at the right place and it just looks spooky and not right at all. That was a really great idea, except these are my prescription glasses and they're polarized, and the screen on my laptop is also polarized. So if I have my head completely straight, I can't see my screen. If I go like this, I can see it. If I go like this, I can see it. And here it's like, oh, I think we're talking about bind? I'm not sure. So if you're kind of curious about my bizarre body language, or more bizarre than it normally is, that's what's going on. Okay, so back to the substance. So, at the end of the last exercise, in the end of the last section, I gave you an exercise to try and clean up these, add some more information to these mutate statements here, right? So, this is where I was at the end of my recording, and I had added a rank variable. So this is saying that the computing the ranked associative strength for the woman back variable. And we said, hey, the woman back variable is our backwards association, so we've got a type equals backwards. So the third thing we need to do, and once again, I need to remember that I have a second keyboard. I'm really good at this, really, really smart person. Okay, so word equals woman. So because woman is the word to which we are doing this association. The fourth variable that we wanted to add is what I've called associate. And that, one day I will learn this new keyboard I've got here. The associate variable is, what is the name of the variable in the data frame that stores the name of the word that to which it's associate, to which, in this case, woman is associated. So because this is a backwards associate, the Q is the associate of woman, so rather than the response. It might be a little clearer if I just grab everything there that I've just done and go up to the woman forwards associate and go again, Command Shift M to get my pipe, enter, and then I'm just going to go paste. Okay, so what I've got here for woman forward, we've got rank is same as before. Oh, type, better fix that one. So we'll go, that is for word, and word is woman still. But now, in a forward association, what we're saying is that given woman as the Q word, what is the response? So the associate in this case is the response variable. So let's just delete that and go response there. If it helps if you spell it correctly. And it also helps if I remember, for consistency with my code elsewhere, I think I've been calling it backward and not backwards. Okay, so we've got that. And all I have to do now is copy that. So we wanted to do the man forward mutate statement. And I'll go paste here. Ugh, that's really annoying. Okay. So here we've got rank, type is still forward because it's man forward. The word is man rather than woman. And the associate is still response because it's the man. It's a forward association. Okay. So let's do the last one. And put a thing. Hello, there we go. Okay, pipe to mutate, so that's me pasting the thing that I just did. So we're going to go back here, and so for the man back, I've just taken the mutate statement that I used for the woman back, and I've just changed the word to man. So I'll save that. That is, as we just take a moment to step slightly outside of it. That's the answer to this exercise. So what you might notice, and what I want you to think about, but I'm not going to show you the answer to today, is this is kind of repetitive, right? I've got woman forward, this is a bunch of code, and I've got woman back, and it's almost the same code. Then I've got man forward, which is almost the same code, but not quite. Man back, that's almost the same code. Generally speaking, when you find yourself cutting and pasting and doing the same thing many times, there's an easier way to do it, right? That is, as I was saying in the first set of lectures, it is a mindless repetitive task. And any time you find yourself faced with a mindless repetitive task, there's probably a way to automate it and make that the computer's problem. So there is a way of doing all of this stuff that I've shown you with these four variables and reducing it to just one piece of code that you run four times. But I'm not going to show you that today because it's reliant on skills I haven't taught you yet. But I want to flag that that is an area where we could make this code better in the future. We can do that by writing a function. But that is a topic later. In the meantime, let's just check that this has all worked. So if I go Control Shift S to source my script, Control L to clear my screen, and what should we have here? So we've got, let's have a look at man forward. It's always a good idea to check your results as you go. So we've got 8 variables, that appears to have something sensible. Man back, and it's got, yep, the same variables, and you'll notice now that I am hoping from here it is a little bit more obvious why I've asked you to do this mutation. So rank is now our output variable. Type tells you what type of association it is, forward or backwards. Word is what word is being associated, and associate is the outcome, the name of the word that is being produced in a response, or is the cue that led to the response. That was not amazingly phrased. The key thing is that when organized in this fashion, rather than in the fashion that I have it originally, if you have a look here, so when we have Q, man is always the same in the Q variable for the man forward, and man is always the same in the response variable for man back. And that's going to make it really difficult to frame our analyses later, which is why I have flipped them around. So instead of coding it in terms of Q and response, I've recoded it as a type, word, and associate. So you've basically got the word. So man and woman, it's always the same pair of words, but the ordering is broken apart and kept in this separate variable called type. And so that is going to make it a lot easier for us to do the kinds of analysis we would want to do. Like if you wanted to do, say, a test to see whether or not the forward associates and the backward associates are different, well, now you've got a clear variable called type that separates out the forward and backward associates. It explicitly codes the information we need. That's the reason for doing all of this. Okay, so that's the solution to the previous exercise. Now let us jump back to the slides and talk about the thing that we really want to do. Really want to do? I'm sure you really want to. I really want to teach this to you. I am getting annoyed at having to have four separate variables. We've got woman forward, woman back, man forward, man back, and they all include the exact same variables. Q, response, strengths, ID, whatever the other ones were, right? They're all exactly the same, and so couldn't I just stick them on top of each other? Well, I can, and the way that I do that in R is to use the bind rows function, so that is part of dplyr as well, and for some reason it won't highlight. There we go. So we've got bind rows, and I'm just going to store all four of these in one big variable called gender. And that gives me this as my output. So it's again a tibble, or a data frame, keeping in mind from what we said earlier. Tibbles are essentially the same thing as data frames. I will tend to use those words interchangeably, but they are strictly speaking, not quite identical, but hopefully we will not run into the reasons they are different until much later in this class. Anyway, we have our tibble that has 505 rows and 8 columns. So there are 8 variables in here, 500 of things. What I'm going to do to make my life a little bit cleaner, easier, is I have 8 rows in here, and I kind of don't need them all for my data analysis. All I actually need are these last 5. I just want to keep ID through associate. And so I'm going to do another select statement, just like I did last time when introducing select. But this is another example of showing you how select can be used in a little bit more of a useful way than listing every single variable. If I were to try to select them by typing each variable, I'd have to pipe from the bind row statement to select ID, comma rank, comma type, comma word, comma associate, and that's becoming really annoying. And wouldn't it be easier just to be able to say, okay, select everything starting from the ID column and keep all the columns all the way through to associate? That's where you can use the little colon operator here. So if I go select ID to associate, it produces this as the output. So now it keeps those 5 variables there. So let's have a go at this. I'll have a go at this myself, and I have again pressed the wrong button. Go back over here, and I bring up my source window again. So now what I'm going to do is try and clean up my script a little bit. Like, this is starting to get quite long, you'll notice. I've got up to, 59 lines, and that's kind of irritating. And it helps to break things up into sections. So what I'm going to do is we'll go up to the start, and we'll just have, create some rows there, and we'll go code, and I think, what am I looking for? I always forget. Insert section, it's right at the top. Insert section, Control-Shift-R. And I'm going to give this a name, and it'll go, okay, I will call this one setup. Just give it it's a boring name. I think I called it something else in the other scripts. That automatically just gives you this nice visual separation between sections. I generally think it is a good idea to write in sections. Like, it's just a comment, it doesn't do anything substantively, like it doesn't make a big difference other than it helps you organize your script, and you will thank yourself later for having nice clean scripts. So let's go over here. I'm going to create a new section. There's a keyboard shortcut, so I can go Control Shift R. So that's how I will do it. So it's asking me for another name, so I'm going to go call this one extract for associate data frames. Okay, so now that's the name of that section, and I'll save that. Now that we have finished over here, I'm going to move down to here, and I'm going to create a new section. Bind the variables together. And now that I've organized it in this fashion, and again that was Control Shift R to bring up the shortcut thing, I'm going to create my new, this is the head tilt so that I can see, gender gets, what was it again? Bind rows. I'll take a moment here to notice, if you want to stack things vertically, you use bind rows. So it goes boom, 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 boom. That's bind rows. There is another function, which I'm not going to talk to you about, but you can imagine what it does, called bind cols, which binds them column-wise. So it goes boom, 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 horizontally, and it stacks them all side by side. But typically, I find I end up wanting to bind things vertically more often than horizontally, so we'll use bind rows. Okay, so now I'm just going to do, and then we just type them in. So we go man back, man forward, woman back, woman forward, and So if we go like, we just go like that, just to run that one line, and we'll check that gender is what we thought it would be. Yep, there it is. There's our 505 by 8 tibble. Now what I'm going to do is add that select statement that I showed. So we'll go back up here, and then I go Control Shift M, and then go select ID, not OD. Generally very useful to show ID rather than overdose. Associate. No, I'm good. Okay, I am normally a better typist, I swear. Okay, so now I run that line again and just clear my screen, make this big again, and gender. Gender? I doubt that's going to work. There we go. So now we have just the five columns that we want to work with and all of the rows that we need. And this is a nice, succinct representation of those aspects to the data that we actually care about. And that is sort of our goal here. All right, so let's go back to the slides. We do have another task to undertake. So if we go back here, I want to call attention to the fact that the purpose of this analysis is going to be to look at whether the forward and backward associates of woman and man are different to each other in some systematic way. I'm really not interested in the associations between woman and man directly. Like, it's more about what other words do they associate with. So I want to do a filter statement to get rid of those. And so here's what we're going to do. What I just want to do is grab all of the rows in which associate is not equal to man and associate is not equal to woman. So basically just get rid of just those rows where somebody's produced man or woman as the response. And that will get rid of the ones that we don't want. So I tab back over here and I go back to my source window. Back here and we go. Pipe to filter. And we go associate. Now, this is an important thing to note. In the slide, remember when you saw the not equals thing? The way that you actually type that, a not equal sign in R, is with a exclamation mark and then an equal sign. And I don't think you've run into that yet in this class. So this is equal to, this is not equal to. So anything where associate is not equal to man. And we also want to keep cases where associate is not equal to woman. Not equal to woman. So that's what we need to do. Okay, I will save this. I do my usual thing of sourcing, running the whole script from the beginning. Okay, let's clear my screen again with Ctrl L. Now let's have a look at this. Gender is now a 501 by 5 tibble. So we've got rid of the four rows in which man and woman were associated with each other, because that's not amazingly useful for the analysis that we want to run. Okay. And back here, I can do another analysis. So this is going back to the original lectures when I, the module earlier about Say Hello to Your Data. I talked about grouping by and summarize. So this is an example of, we can do a quick check to make sure we had the right answer. So we can take gender, pipe to group by, word and type, and count. All of this is really not amazingly interesting, but I just want to point out that count is a handy way of adding up the total number of cases that fall into a certain group. So we've got 288 backward associates to man, 199 backward associates to woman, and 7 forward associates to both. And that's the right answer. That's the key thing. Okay, so now I will leave you to your own devices, yes. I'll leave you to your own devices. Open up exercise dplyr 06, shocking, take a look at the instructions. It will walk you through an exercise in using bind rows. And I will, again, stop there.